Hello people, welcome! Let's see how to be precise and how to export properly in Adobe InDesign CC. Leave comments if you find mistakes. In professional projects, you may need to create and design all following strict specifications. For example, a line with a precise length or the area occupied by the text. There are two main tools that help you at doing this, the measurements and the guides. When you draw any object or text, a small box appears, indicating you height, h, and width, w, of the frame that contains the object. This means that, as height, is intended the maximum height of the object, and so the same for the width. In case of 1D objects like a segment, its length will be indicated under an L letter. Plus, on top and on the left, you have all the properties of the selected object. X and Y are the exact position of the object in your sheet. X starts from the extreme left of your project, while Y starts from the very top. Mind that these don't take into account the safe zone in pink and violet contours around the sheet. Use W and H or L to set the sides of the object created very carefully. And so you can set inclination, skew, and so on. Use the arrow buttons or simply type the correct values. Heights and lengths use a measurement unit that can be pixels, meters, inches, and so on. To change them, go to Edit, Preferences, and then select units and increments. It's enough to change units for horizontal and vertical. Change stroke instead to set the unit for the thickness. You also have the guides. Guides are used to help you at drawing or moving objects and are never rendered in the end as much as layers, frames, or safe zone contours. You can disable these through the first icon on top. To make a last check, you can make measurements on your project directly. In the toolbar, you can enable the Measure tool inside the eyedropper icon. This opens the info window if you click on your project. If you hold your click and drag, a black segment appears. H and W represent the height and the width of the virtual rectangle that contains the black segment. The value next to the angle symbol is the inclination, respect to X axis. D1 represents the radius of the virtual circumference that contains the segment. Pay attention to your pointer. If the arrow is black, you will place the anchor point, so where the segment starts, right there. If the arrow is white, it means that you will snap to a vertex or an edge point of an object or its frame, so the anchor will stick to it. When you find a black cross, you will edit an anchor point, or you will move the segment without changing anything of its inclination or length. You can measure the position of a point, checking the X and the Y values while you hover your mouse on your project. So you can use all this information to build your project correctly, for example to accomplish requirements or to fix external images imported to your project. Then, when you are done, you can go on exporting. You can't use save or save as. In this way, you would save your project as an InDesign project that you can open again later to edit your work. To export it in printable formats, you need to go to File and then to Export. Choose the format you prefer and then you can go and print it. This is all. Check our channel to discover more professional softwares.